Hello there, Internet. Mogwai here, and I got another Legends of Runeterra video for you guys today. And today we're going to keep showcasing the KDA cards. I don't know if I pronounced that right, but yeah, we're going to keep getting it. Is that what the group says? I'm not really sure what their catchphrase is, but we're going to go get it. And we're actually not going to go get it. No, we're going to be using something else. Where is the deck? There we go. Bruised by Trolls. This is a Feel the Rush Swain Trundle deck that was designed by Bruised by God. Normally, the majority of the decks that I share on my channel, I have built myself. But this one is a deck that I stumbled upon. I didn't really face it on ladder, but I checked out one of his streams and I saw him playing this, and I thought it would look really cool. There's a lot of things that I like about this deck, and I figured like it would be a nice way to showcase the big boy, or big girl rather, spell in Feel the Rush from Freljord. This is a spell that a lot of you guys are used to seeing in the more standard variant of ramp, which is Trundle with Tryndamere. I didn't want to do that because I think you guys have seen that deck enough, those of you who play ranked. It's nothing really new to contribute, even though I do like showcasing meta decks every now and then. I wanted to take a different approach, and I really liked this one because there are a lot of perks of combining Swain and Trundle in a Freljord Noxus mix, and I think this deck really does highlight a lot of that, and it's a very, very solid win condition play with the Feel the Rush, though this deck, needless to say, does have quite a few glaring weaknesses. In fact, one of the problems this deck has mainly is the fact that it is weaker than the Trundle Tryndamere version. It doesn't really handle that matchup well because Shadow Isles has access to Vengeance and Ruination, which are very much devastating towards this archetype, especially Ruination. Ruination is very hard, which makes us vulnerable to that variant. But there are certain matchups in which we are just better suited, and there's a very, very nice curve that we are looking at here, especially with access to ramp in the form of the Wolf Rider, right? So because we're playing a total of three copies of Leviathan, three copies of Feel the Rush, and a one-off of Captain Farron, we have a total of seven, eight mana or higher cards that can turn into potentially 10 if we count Trundle's five-turn play into an Ice Pillar. Though we're not going to take that into account because we're going to look at this number, since it's very relevant for our turn 2 and turn 4 plays, as we're running a full set of the Troll Scavenger, who grants himself plus 3 attack if you behold an 8 cost card in hand, making him an amazing 2 drop if you're able to enable him. There's not really much out there that beats a 2 mana 4-3, even though you can run into the pesky 2 mana 3-2 that can block into you, but as a 4-3 for 2 mana, you can basically trade with anything that you want at that state of the game, right? Which gives you a really solid power play that helps out a lot, especially against other more aggressive or mid-range based decks. As we are running also a full set of the Troll Ravager. This card is fantastic in this region and champion combination because we are running a full set of Avalanche, right? So this is a pretty crazy 4-drop if you think about it. A 3-5 with the regeneration. We've seen how strong the regeneration keyword is. It really does make 5-drops like Trundle and Garen really way stronger than they should be initially, right? So the same should apply to a 4-drop that has quite a bit of health, less attack, but just enough to block into fearsome units. Troll Ravager is a really solid 4-drop to go into, and applies a lot of pressure and can help you rebuild the board state by defending and blocking and utilizing that constant healing as a resource to take down opposing units little by little, right? But we also have another very important 4-drop that I mentioned prior, and that is the Wolf Rider here. We're trying to enable the Wolf Rider by basically attacking with one of our earlier units or by going for a Death's Hand with our spell mana. This allows us to ramp one mana while also developing a unit onto the board. If we're able to enable Wolf Rider, it becomes a much better play than the likes of Catalyst of Aeons because we're not really sacrificing much tempo at all, which is one of the biggest downsides to going for ramp, right? Which is why Wolf Rider really puts in the work in this deck. She allows us to get the Feel the Rush turn one turn earlier, because the way this deck plays out, you know, turn 8 onwards is pretty straightforward the majority of the time. We want to be dropping either Captain Farron or Leviathan on turn 8 after we manage to accelerate into it by one turn with Wolf Rider. And then on turn 9, we want to make sure that we have our spell mana packed full, so that we have a total of 12 mana with our 9 regular mana, so we can go for Field of Rush and get out a 10-10 Trundle and 10-10 Swain for what is pretty much a game-winning play. That is what we are aiming for here, as we have a full set of Kindly Tavern Keeper to help us build up and recover some damage when we're facing aggressive decks that can otherwise take us down before we get to that point. A full set of Culling Strike is also very important for the Tahm Kench Soraka matchup, though I do feel like that matchup can still be really tricky, because if you don't draw Culling Strikes, the fact that we don't have any landmark removal here can leave us a little bit vulnerable, since a lot of our removal itself besides Culling Strike is basically based on damage. Avalanche is perhaps the most key card in this deck, because it is the best way to ensure a Swain level up. You want to hold on to Avalanche until the right moment to not only get as much value out of it from a card advantage perspective, but also to level up Swain. The more units you hit, the more you'll progress to level up to a Swain level up. And sometimes Avalanche is almost all you need to get the level up from Swain if you time it right, which is why it's super crucial in this build. And obviously we're playing a deck with Swain. We play a full suite of Ravenous Flock, and we're playing Froyor, so we play Troll Chant with Froyor, which actually synergizes with Swain really well, because we can utilize the -2 to remove a fearsome blocker potentially, and connect onto the Nexus with this badass motherfucker right here. And that is the deck list right there. Not much more to say about it. Like I said, some weaknesses here and there. It's not a tier 1 list by any means, but I think I really like this deck building by Bruised by God. And I think this deck is a very fun alternate take on Swain. I also want to be looking into bringing back Yasuo Swain. I feel like that sort of archetype can have a really solid place in the current meta, so watch out for that. But right now I'm focusing on showcasing the KDA cards, right? Like we showcased Go Hard, we showcased Out of the Way yesterday. Today we're doing Field of Rush. Tomorrow, you know, it may be give it all. We'll see about that. I gotta finish the deck that I'm designing around that one. But that's basically all I gotta say. I'm a soul day. Thank you guys for watching. Stay tuned for daily Legends of Runeterra content. Hope you enjoy the video, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. All right, here we go. So it's standard Swain versus edgy cool Swain, pun intended. Let's go ahead and swap these two. I'm gonna keep this Troll Scavenger because I don't ever like mulliganing away Ravenous Flock, and this enhances my chances of finding that 8 drop to enable the Troll from reaching their full potential, as we have the Ramp and Wolf Rider here as well. In this matchup, getting the Plunder is gonna be easier said than done, but we do have the novelty factor, and what I mean by this is that we have the surprise factor, basically. We will be able to... That gives us a good target for a Ravenous Flock, though, even though we do have Avalanche here. Let's see what they do. I mean, this is the easiest Avalanche of my life, which is why we're going to be passing initially. And then getting a nice 2-for-1 trade here. Knocking them out and getting a nice level of progression for Swain, as now we drop the Scavenger.
Pray.
Now we hunt. We didn't play him prior because that way we don't have him take any damage from the Avalanche here. And next turn, we are very likely to develop another Troll Scavenger. And from that point onwards, it's really about getting that Plunder. If we can get that Plunder and play our Leviathan one turn earlier, I would be so happy. He's really running out of... I'm doing this.
Let me smell something. Deal me in. Who says I don't share?
I probably should have passed there, honestly.
Lady Luck is smiling. This way.
That's good.
Vision to see what others cannot.
We feast tonight, Varg.
All right.
getting...
I may want to resort to...
I think I'm gonna want to resort to an avalanche potentially. The problem is I don't want to overcommit here.
Be here and ready for fight!
Huh, now whole hunting party here.
Dare oppose Noxus.
Bastard.
Getting that prior damage there.
Destination in sight.
Is actually really important. But this ramp effect is really strong. Now we call these right. We have the Ravenous Flock for the Swain, but we will not resort to it until he's threatening us with an attack. Otherwise, we want to keep the Swain on the board. This really allows us to shut him down. We are going to try... I'm just going to block here. Honestly. I don't know what he's attacking. You know why? He wanted to enable the Riptide Rex. Shut down, baby! Shut down, wow. That was pretty dominant. Like I said, dude, the Wolf Rider. That avalanche early on was pretty sweet, but that Wolf Rider, like, in a mirror match like that, ramping into Leviathan one turn earlier is so backbreaking. Man, that was like the perfect game for us. Oh my god, like everything went right. Almost everything. That Twisted Fate setup, like I should have passed there probably. But I mean, it didn't end up mattering in the end, which is nice. The Troll Scavengers putting in the work early on as well. Just really good showing for the deck against like its actual like, you know, meta option. So yeah, let's go for another one. M. Cabeza Bolo. I'm pretty sure this guy's Spanish. I'm 99% sure this guy's Spanish. And another... We go from Swain to Trundomir. Ooh, I love this Wolf Rider. I don't think I need the Troll Chant, and I don't think I need... I mean, the Kindly Tavern Keeper does give me a play to go for. But I am actually going to... I'm gonna do this. Even though we can definitely draw into more. Perfect. 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 I love seeing the Scavenger. That's what I really wanted. Scavenger's a good card, man.
Footprints here.
2 mana, 4/3. What's not to like? That's what I really like about combining Swain with Freljord. Like, it allows me... Like, first of all, Frayne. The guy combined. In my brain, I went Freljord and Swain. Frayne. Swain with Troll Chant is really neat, first of all. Let's see what they do here.
Come on in.
We are going to...
What were you...
We're going to develop the Kindly Tavern Keeper because we really want to plunder. We must plunder here. We'll offer him a good trade here with the Tavern Keeper into the Scavenger, which is great because we're technically trading a 2-drop for a 3-drop. We get the Plunder, which allows us to Wolf Rider, and that's the tits. They just don't expect her. Her voice line is something like, ah.
Smell that garg.
Fear.
And now we are one step ahead of the ramp deck. Feels good.
Ice to meet.
Hilarious.
vision to see what others.
This name, like, I'm always confusing it for Trump. And that's that's fitting considering the elections, I guess. I do like the troll chant here, honestly. I do like it very much. But I can't just go wide. Like, what's the reason? I mean, because I want to ramp as well, right? Like, the more mana I have, the better. So going for an open attack feels like it's just overall a better call. He could have a hush. But that's basically it.
Patience is a tactician's greatest tool.
Let's take this outside.
I'm just gonna go for the attack.
Nothing's tougher than a troll.
I don't want to waste this just yet. We get to ramp again. Support. There it is. Let's resort to the regular Ravenous Flock first. Because if they have a troll chant, then we will be fishing for the other one. So funny how we're like, we're ahead of the Aurelion Soul Trundle deck in mana. that's actually pretty wild. Yeah, like, he could have a Star Shaping, right? But he's already played one. If he does have a Star Shaping, it's fine. Like, it could be worse. Really do want to deal with Trundle, though, because we do have a Boar State that's actually very vulnerable to Ice Quake, which is Trundle's signature spell. So if we were not able to deal with Trundle there, then our entire board could be wiped by that card. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. They played down the Warding Stones. They haven't gone for ramp, though, but we're going to be at 9. But that means next turn they're going to be at 8, right? Yep. Which means they can drop the Ice Pillar, which will just vulnerable one of these Wolf Riders. What is this? It's an Avalanche. I'm actually okay with this, I think. I want him to work a little bit harder for it, right? Yeah. Especially because doing this allows us to clear the ramp. Yep. Yeah, good use of our card there, because now we get to do this, which prevents them from playing the pillar, slows them down, leaves us wide open to another Avalanche, but at this point we don't care because we just play a Leviathan. And I don't know what they can do to a Leviathan. They can't even play Mindsplitter here. They need another Avalanche. It's that simple, really. A second Avalanche will do the work.
Snow Sunder smash all the things!
Destination in sight!
Bring these lands to their knees.
Incoming Avalanche is gonna hurt. If there's no Avalanche, this game is done. This game is super done. It's Avalanche or bust. It's funny though, because Avalanche will, like, it will really do a lot here. Like, clearing four units like this while also preserving a legit blocker here. Oh! Okay, Equinox can still be a thing. He also picked it up, like, really fast, which definitely makes me believe that, okay. Well, that's fine. That's fine. Equinox would have been worse than that. We still have a Swain in hand. And we're all about that open attack. Especially considering they get to play the Ice Pillar this turn. We're not messing around. Ooh! Are we? Are we messing around? What do they got for this shit? What do they have for Field of Rush? Fuck it. I'm going for it. No reason not to. Like, I'm just thinking about how I can get punished. If he plays Mind Splitter, I kill him. If he plays, like, Ice Quake, I pretty much kill him. I don't know how to answer that. I try, but I fail.
By my hand, will Noxus rise.
Grand General.
And he just summoned from our hand. Is that, that can't be our last Swain, though. That's one Swain. Wait. We didn't lose Swain here, though. We lost Swain here.
This one's on the house.
I think I definitely want to destroy this.
We are at war.
How about another round? We're attacking like this. The reason why we're attacking like this is because this Fearsome is forcing him to block with the Troll Ravager. Even though he could very easily have a Flash Freeze.
Meet Snow Thunder!
Which makes it so that, you know, right now we're easily representing lethal. Still. And also getting rid of his pillar, which is actually pretty important. Because this would have been the same way the other way around, because he could chump block with this anyways. That's not enough. He still needs to prevent 2 damage to stay alive, right? Yeah. No, actually, oh, okay. No, yeah, he still needs to prevent 2. Otherwise, our ship will do it. Who's gonna close up? We're looking really good. This Leviathan will win the game automatically. Oh, he's fishing for the answer. Oh, will he Yu-Gi-Oh? Will he Yu-Gi-Oh? He does not. He does not Yu-Gi-Oh, it seems. He needs an Equinox. Oh, you're done. Guiding Touch. Got him. There we go. I like Trundle the Curd. I'm not crazy about the character. I don't know. I do like the art of the trolls a lot, though. That's something that I really, really like about. Like, I love the art from Troll Scavenger. And I also like Troll Ravager as well. They're also cool cards, you know? Like, definitely underestimated them quite a bit when they were revealed with the expansion at first. Just cool stuff, and we can definitely expect Trundle to be slightly nerfed soon. But it's not like he's breaking the game like Lee Sin or anything like that. You know, he's just a little bit too good right now, but... Yeah, Wolf Rider putting in the massive work these two games. MVP! Absolute MVP. And just really fun shit, man. Let's go for another one. Okay, it's all about the mirrors today. Now, see, one of the differences between our last matchup and this one is the region. We're not facing target anymore. We're facing Shadow Owls, and that means Ruination. Not only Vengeance, but also Ruination is a spooky thing. I'm going to drop... I'm going to keep the Trundle, but I'm going to drop everything else. Actually, no, I'm going to do a Fumulian. I think, I mean, Trundle is good on curve, though. Let's keep Trundle. I should be able to find some early game, right? Maybe not. Well, we found the Plunder Enabler. That's great. This is great. We're actually, like, the cool thing is Troll Chant doesn't stop this. I'm gonna play Troll Scavenger. I'm gonna act like I'm disappointed by the results, but the reality is I'm fully aware of this because I want to enable the Wolf Rider.
Smell that arg.
Fear. Now, Feel the Rush is actually...
What did you find?
Alright, that's pretty good.
The trolls are going to war!
Ready when you are. Always ready.
Would have been nice to have this scavenger also be a 4-3, you know, but can't ask for everything, I guess. Feel the rush is potentially a bit of a liability here. I do like the idea of going for an avalanche, though, potentially answering to... Smashing. I don't want to overcommit to, like, a... But then again, I could surprise him with an avalanche. I attack with everything. It's a lot of damage. I mean, only Trollchan prevents this, so... I'm gonna go for it. Especially because this also allows me to level up Swain immediately.
A little snowball out.
I would not have Field of Rush next turn anyways. Could play Field of Rush next turn. I won't be able to do that if I spend my mana on the Leviathan. If I play the Leviathan now, I put him on quite the clock here.
Come on!
But this clock may not be enough.
Loyalty through conquest.
The problem is the threat of ruination.
Brings me closer to deliverance. Troll out. I smell a fight.
Yeah, he has exactly the mana for ruination, which is a big predicament here. If I go for Field of Rush now and he ruinates, he basically wins the game. If I go for Leviathan and he ruinates, he basically wins the game.
Patience is a tactician.
I don't have a good attack here. Do I just have to take risks? This is a very, very powerful attack if I have to go for it. I have to hope he doesn't have ruination at this point. That's what I gotta believe in. That's why this matchup is much worse than the Aurelion Soul one. The fear of the board wipe. Ruination is just really good in this meta. I mean, at least I know he can't deny this. But does that mean he doesn't have ruination? Oh shit. Oh shit. Oh shit. I mean, he still has to have a vengeance or something, right? But the thing about this...
Smashing.
Leave them nothing.
Now we go. One smack will do.
I mean, we're representing Lethal on Trundle here, so he needs to answer that. I should have attacked with these two first, right? Yeah, I messed up my ordering. I definitely messed up my ordering.
You don't stand a chance. You'll need more than that.
Okay.
Noxus!
I have no way to enable this though, unfortunately.
To battle! This is gonna be fun!
Footprints here.
Gonna lead off with the scavenger.
A conquest for Empire.
And we gotta drop the Leviathan. I mean, I'm not sure what he's crying about. He has, like, there's no way he doesn't have an answer, right? Like, he must have an answer at this point. My opponent, like, likes to emote, but he's not in a precarious position here, I don't think. Okay. I mean, that's definitely not what I was expecting.
Living, dead,
no matter.
Vision to see what others cannot.
Now, I could attack here. But the odds of him having like a vengeance or something are extremely high. So if I attack right now and I drag these two to the side, I'm gonna lose my two ice pillars. I'm gonna pass here.
My blade grows restless.
Because the good thing about this.
Dark in the sky.
Search little light.
I'm able to lock him down, and this Captain Farron just came from the heavens. This Captain Farron could mean everything. The problem is we miss out on lethal by so damn little. If only I had a... It's a bit bizarre. If only I had a flash freeze or something. I get this attack now. He wants to clear space. The avalanche, or
avalanche!
It doesn't really matter. If he has Atrocity, that's a card he top decked. But I mean, yeah, it's bound to happen. It's bound to happen. GG. Good game.
We missed out on lethal by one, which is pretty devastating. That was a close game. To be fair, the way it played out, I definitely think we were bound to lose a little bit earlier. That was a good match. It's just that we weren't able to really close the gap there. I think the matchup is tough. I think it's clear that out of all, like, it's funny because we ran into, oh, we got some new stuff, by the way. We ran into like some some late game driven strategies, right? Like we ran to Swain, Twist of Fate, and then we played Trundle early in the solo, and now Trundle, Tryndamere. Trundle, Tryndamere definitely feels like the benchmark here. Like it's hard for us to beat that because they have Ruination. And Ruination just like bodies us so hard. Like we were lucky. We lost that game and yet we were lucky that our opponent did not draw Ruination earlier, because that would have shut us down much quicker. I'm still surprised to see so many War Mother decks though. I feel like Field of Rush is definitely better. Especially because it closed out games faster, but maybe I'm wrong about that regarding Trundle, Tryndamere. I don't really play that archetype too much. So yeah. GG. Didn't go our way. I cry every time. Let's go for another one. Doom Train. Well, we do have triple Culling Strike. Not one, not two, but three Culling Strikes, baby. So let's try to capitalize on that. We have Swain. I like Swain a lot. I like Death's Hand. The problem with this hand is that we don't have an 8-mana unit, right? So I am going to drop the Swain. I'm going to drop everything except the Troll Scavenger to enhance my chances of drawing into an 8-drop to Behold. Now's the time. Now's the time. Let's pass first. And as they go for a landmark, we will go for the Death's Hand. Preventing them from getting this off as much as possible is going to be key. There is our Captain Farron.
Pray.
Problem is attacking through this is going to be a bit of a bitch. I'm going to pass. I'm gonna wait to see what he does.
Close your eyes and the stars will fill you with their...
Okay, so yeah, there's a lot of things that he can do for 3 mana.
Be here and ready for fight!
Now whole hunting party here.
I'll play a Troll Ravager.
If I kill you, I don't fortune, stupid!
We're trying to slow down their process as much as I can. They struggle. This avalanche is really tempting. But I feel like this is fine here. I could attack. Double avalanche can go a long way clearing this board, but I feel like I need a little bit more. What a pass.
Pablo's been down! Let his knee out!
Ah! I told your ancestors to protect!
He's gonna be able to start drawing cards. But clearing a good portion of their board is really important here. I'm gonna go for an avalanche. All of a sudden, we're looking at a big threat here to take us down. Ah, oh, man.
your crap soup, Lassie, please!
It's not soup! You've been drinking this?
I've been propagating quite the appetite.
I see feast in your future.
Shut down! Yeah, unfortunately, we took a huge hit from this thing. We drew no calling strikes. No way to apply pressure. Maybe I should not have mulliganed the Swain. I can't really resort to Leviathan or anything more. GG. Good game. Ah! Tough match there. I mean, we don't have any landmark removal, which is something that maybe I could change. But to be fair, with triple calling strike, I don't feel like we should have had as big of a problem. I also think we should have kept Swain. Yeah. Maybe play more passively until we can go for the field of rush win as well. But it's hard. It's hard to say. Like, that's a weird matchup. I definitely think we needed calling strike and Swain. So maybe mulliganing Swain was a mistake. I mean, I just didn't want to draw, like, too many Swains, right? But Ravenous Flock can be a really key card there as well, because it deals a lot of damage. Avalanche was kind of like a... It was a pretty risky card, because if I, like... My opponent could very well capitalize on it, right? But I also feel like I have to threaten their board, because they have their ways of pinging themselves. But oh, let's see if we can... definitely some weaknesses this archetype has. But this is a pretty damn good looking hand. I'm going to keep this. We have the Field of the Rush to enable this Troll Scavenger. We have Kindly Tavern Keeper to mitigate a little bit of early damage we may take. And we have Wolf Rider, which we can potentially enable. Only a fool would enter battle. Especially because our units are generally going to be bigger.
Pray.
Though enabling the Wolf Rider will be easier said than done.
Her flowers bring the moonlight with them.
I'm thinking about whether it'll be better to
let me smell something.
Take the chill up. Yeah, getting these Wolf Riders to go through without Death's Hand. Death's Hand would be a very nice way to enable this. The idea is next turn we will be dropping, likely to be Trundle here.
Darkness hides in my path.
See what he does.
Your weapon, Sunwind.
I'm still waiting for them to develop a big unit here. Like, they still have the mana for Nocturne, and that's something that we gotta take into account always. I am fine with this attack. I can in fact trade my 3-3 into the 3-1, because then... There it is. There it is. Now we play Trundle.
Nice to meet
you. Trundle gives us the free block here, basically.
Whatever the cost. It's our time.
All right, so let's get rid of the beefier units.
Let's talk about your dad.
We're gonna trade like this.
We'll be free.
And then we will attack with Trundle. And depending on what they do, we'll do one thing or the other. If they do block here, they will enable our plunder, which will allow us to level up Trundle next turn. And that's what we will be going for. Even though it does leave us more vulnerable to an attack next turn, but next turn we can just... Okay. Let's go with this. Even though Kindly Tavern Keeper to Kindly Tavern Keeper felt pretty good there curve-wise, I am going to resort to this. Because that means that next turn we can level up Trundle, and the turn after that we can feel the rush. So next turn we're looking at an Ice Pillar into double Kindly Tavern Keeper most likely. Or probably Tavern Keeper into Swain. Yeah, I would argue that's best. Depends on how much pressure we're receiving. That Cooling Strike is nice, even though it's easy for our opponent to navigate around. I haven't really seen Zenith Blade in Nightfall at all, ever. I feel it's a very low tempo play. I don't want to resort to Cooling Strike here though, even if he does set it up there. I'm confident I can take the hit. Especially because if he has a... Yeah. Okay, so he has another one in his hand. That's good to know.
You're in control, Lance, now. It's good to be the king.
If he has like the Nightfall elusive unit, then I mean we know he has a Senate Blade.
Devotion to battle.
Leave your backs at the door. Now we have a couple of options here. We can go Swain. This doesn't really accomplish too much. Or we can go another. We can play it. No, we actually want to go for the rush here, anyways. So we may just want to resort to Calling Strike now. Okay. Let's get parting. We're going in. He's down on very few cards, but these two elusives do make me nervous. I'm not gonna lie. I need to force the blocks out of him. So by dragging this with my Trundle, I will force him to block with one of these two, unless he has another. Like, that's why I went for the Culling Strike. Because if I went for Kylian Tavern Keeper, I wouldn't have the space for Feel the Rush here, right? So by going for Culling Strike, I took away a buff from his hand. Yeah, that Pill Cascade got him value, but... You know, it's one Pale Cascade less that I have to deal with this deck, right? And if the Anna's not on the board... Alright. Definitely concerning. Let's drag you here.
Leave them nothing. Let's take this outside.
I do want to attack these two. Like right now, with these in the back, without you.
Come on, come on!
We are at war.
Press to block with one of these onto this. Then he still has two to block here.
One smack will do.
Alright, that's the second Pale Cascade, very important. Avalanche would also be pretty good here. He needs to be wary that if he leaves himself that vulnerable, like he's being pretty greedy here, but I guess that's what he's gotta do, right? Leviathan is there, it's neat.
Ours is the one true light.
The moon is our queen, the night her kingdom.
This is huge, because now I know their entire hand. This is huge. Knowing their entire hand is a very, very big deal. Because now I know that they cannot kill me. We still have three blockers here, but they can drag one of these out. I'm just making sure I'm doing things right here. Right now, if he attacks, everything has fearsome. But these three blockers, I can deal with these, even if he drags, and these two don't kill me. So I pass here. Again, we have a total of three blockers here. We don't die.
I will be heard.
Just making sure that my math is not off. But we don't die. Because feel the rush. It's very, very powerful. It's very hard to spook these guys. They went to a concert, man. They've seen it all. They've seen anime pop star groups.
Indecision is the first of many.
As they wondered what happened to humanity. What went wrong? So you're not gonna scare us with a few, you know, nightmare stories, Nocturne.
You got a problem?
We've been through too much. Just making sure, you know, like I know I'm, I seem like I'm taking my time, but if I were to like choke the game at this point, I would be disappointed in myself. We survive on one.
Destination in sight. Bring these.
Play Leviathan, and we win the game. Gotcha.
Fire!
Fire! The Fire Nation attacked. And won.
Praise the Noctura. Remember this day.
I will remember. Wow, that's a long life though. Oh my god, dude. Okay, we got quite a few games. We ended up going, like, we lost two games, right? Our final score with this deck was nothing too crazy. We went 3-2. 3-2, but at least we stayed positive throughout the entire episode of suffering. No, at least, you know, we did good. Like, we won more than we lost. I like this deck a lot by Bruised by Gods. It's fun. It's a different take. I know he likes to combine Swain and Trundle quite a bit and mix them up. I really do like the way this deck plays out, even though there are some glaring weaknesses. Specifically, the War Mother matchup feels pretty bad, and that is like the most popular deck right now. You know, because aggro is toning down lately because all these Shadow Owl control decks are running around. So, you know, whenever your worst matchup is arguably the most popular and best deck in the meta, that's not really a great thing. But besides that, you know, the Soraka matchup was also weird, but we drew very poorly for that one, I think. And maybe I did not mulligan properly, even though, you know, it wouldn't hurt to have some few extra tech options for that, right? Because if you're able to answer, like, the landmark, then you're just able to shut them down really well. And it's not like, you know, scorching the land or whatever the name of the card is. Scorched Earth is a bad card to run in a Swain deck, even though this deck is less proficient at dealing damage. It kind of like packs a lot of, you know, the power behind like leveling up Swain and Avalanche, and that's pretty much it. So it does have its downsides, but it's very fun to play. And it's definitely competitive. So shout outs to BBG. Really cool deck. Hope you guys enjoyed. Have a solid day. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned for daily Legends of Runeterra content. And the same old outro. That won't change in a while. I'm too lazy for it. And have a good one. Hope you like the games. I'll see you tomorrow.